Russia test firing its new intercontinental ballistic missile nicknamed Satan 2. Now, Russia has released this video of what they say is this test this morning, saying it's capable of striking targets from the North and South Poles, making it harder for the U.S. to target it. This as U.S. tensions with Russia continue to grow. Joining us now live from Moscow with the latest, Phil Black. Phil, can you tell us?
The prince of the power of the air. And, you know, a decade ago, we were told that they were tightening down this arms race, that there would be no more of this, and that they were scaling back the nuclear arsenal. And the story just keeps going on and on and on. And so you have to ask yourself, what is the story behind the story? There's much more to this Satan 2 missile than meets the eye. This is it here. It is called the RS-28 Sarmat. And this is a program that Russia has, of course, to develop these nuclear weapons, this nuclear arsenal that goes over the Arctic instead of over the sea and is much harder for U.S. missiles to track. So here we are now in a new arms race against Russia. And we're told that this is all fueled by Iran and that Iran is the problem and Russia is allies with Iran. And they're not going to allow the U.S. to implement their policy because it will destabilize the Middle East. So this gives Russia, quote-unquote, permission to start another arms race. And this could be one of the catalysts by which the U.S. economy falls, just like we had the Cold War with Russia trying to equalize its armory with the U.S. The same thing could happen in the opposite way with the U.S., going through its economic downturn and trying to keep up with the Russians. This is unbelievable. There's so much more to this story. We also have what the missile was named after. This is called the Sarmatian missile. Sarmat, RS-28 Sarmat, named after the Sarmatians. Who are the Sarmatians? They were the lizard people. This is unbelievable. Any idea that the name derives from the word lizard, Sauros, linking the Sarmatians' use of a reptile-like scale armor and dragon standards, is almost certainly unfounded, they're saying. But of course, we know the truth. They're calling the missile Satan. He's the great lizard, the prince of the power of the air. Now, the Sarmatians were also Iranians. Many of them were dominated by women. Some of the old myths about the Amazon came out of these peoples. And this kind of gives us a snapshot into maybe why the Iran is so important to Russia. That there may be more to this history between Russia and the Iranians. I mean, after all, they are the missile by which they could kill every man, woman, and child in the United States after these Iranian people, the Sarmatians. So you have to wonder what this is really all about, and we'll probably dig deeper into this to find out exactly what's going on. But the Sarmatian people were definitely Iranian peoples, as it says here. Large Iranian confederation that existed in classical antiquity and then flourished all across Southern and Western Europe. These people had reddish hair, it says here. Men of great stature and beauty. Their hair is somewhat yellow, and their eyes are frighteningly fierce. This was the appearance of these peoples. It says here, their women, so long as they are virgins, ride, shoot, throw the javelin, while mounted and fight with their enemies. They do not lay aside their virginity until they have killed three of their enemies. And they do not marry before they have performed the traditional sacred rites. So, these are the peoples that this Sarmat missile was named after. This is the legacy, and this is the truth. So, we'll see what old Putin has in store. Take care and be safe, everyone.